Hi, thank you for joining me in this video. I am Niels Hagort and I work for the Cloud Platform Business Unit at VMware. In this video, I would like to go over the vMotion improvements in vSphere 7. vMotion has been around for quite a while, and with workloads becoming larger and larger, we noticed customers weren't always comfortable using vMotion anymore because of a potential performance impact or a stun time, a switch over time that surpasses the 1 second. With vSphere 7 and the improved vMotion, we are looking to bring back all the live migration capabilities for large workloads as well. So let's have a look at what changed for vSphere vMotion. To understand all the foundational basics for vMotion, please review these blog posts as they will go into great detail on what is happening on the background. First of all, whenever a live migration using vMotion is running, we need to copy memory from the source to destination ESX IOST. This is what we call the memory pre-copy phase. Now, whenever we are copying memory, we need to keep track of all the memory pages that are being overwritten by the guest OS. So this is all about us installing a page tracer and using that page tracer to monitor all the page fires. The page fire is basically that guest OS, that application running inside the virtual machine, trying to write to global system memory. But it can, because that is set to read-only. So now it reaches out to VMM, the virtual machine monitor process. It'll write the memory to the local host memory, and in the same time, call out the migrate module, the vMotion migrate module, mark that page as dirty. Dirty meaning the memory page is being overwritten by the guest OS, and we now need to replicate that page to the destination ESX IOST. These are the basics. The key takeaway here is the page tracer installation and the page fire that we just described. Because in versions prior to vSphere 7, this is what happens on the background. We need to install that page tracer on each and every vCPU that is configured for that specific virtual machine. And stopping meaning that we are only taking microseconds, but in the end, depending on the number of vCPUs configured for a virtual machine, this could lead to serious performance impact. Now, all the vCPUs are setting the PTEs, the page table entries, basically the memory pages, to read-only access. Now we need to stop the vCPUs. Again, we are talking microseconds at the time, but we need to stop them for the page trace installation, but also for all the page firing happening for specific page tables on a vCPU. With vSphere 7, we changed that algorithm. Because now, no longer we need to stop all the vCPUs that are configured for a virtual machine. We just claim one. And that one vCPU will set all the PTEs, all the memory pages, to read-only, and it will process all the page firings. The other vCPUs are just working and doing computations for the workload running inside the virtual machine. So there's a lot less impact for the virtual machine. In the end, we do need to flush the TLBs on all vCPUs, but we do that on different timings instead of all at once. Another improvement that we did is that whenever we set the memory page to read-only, we do that on a 4K granularity. But what if we just set that read-only access on a larger granularity? This way, we are far more efficient in setting read-only access for memory pages. And we are doing so in vSphere 7. This was all about the memory pre-copy phase, but we also have the stun time, the switchover phase. This is basically where all the memory, we reach memory convergence, so memory is all copied to the destination ESX IOST, and we need to switch over. In the switchover phase, we send over a memory bitmap that is containing information about all the memory pages in use by the virtual machine. Now, we send over the last remaining page files in the bitmap, but also include all the information of the memory pages that are already replicated and copied over to the destination ESX IOST. Now, Looking at a example of a 24 terabyte virtual machine, in vSphere 7, we support 6 terabyte, but vMotion is already ready for future virtual machine sizings. Looking at a 24 terabyte virtual machine, we would have a bitmap close to 800 megabyte. Now, that could pose a challenge to transmit to the destination ASICs I host in the stun time. Important to know that the stun time to us at VMware, an SLA of 1 second exists. So we want to make sure that whenever we switch over a workload from the source to destination ASICs I host, that will fit within 1 second. Now, looking at the size of this bitmap, we will also already take up seconds to copy over the bitmap, right? So with vSphere 7, what we did is no longer do we send over the entire bitmap, we compacted the bitmap to only include the information that we really need to be sent over during the switchover phase. Now, we cut that time from 2 seconds to mere milliseconds. Now, what does that look like from a performance view? So this is an example of a vMotion executed for a virtual machine running with a 72 vCPUs and a 512 gig of memory. We are running a HammerDB workload, and what we see whenever we initiate a virtual machine vMotion in 6.7, for example, in the tracing phase, so that is the page installation, page tracer installation and the page fires, we see a performance degradation in vSphere 6.7. And we see a stun time, which is where the vMotion ends in 6.7, of several seconds. Now, with vSphere 7, because of all the optimizations that we did, no longer do we see a performance impact during that memory pre-copy phase. Also noticeable is the stun time that is now still within 1 second instead of multiple seconds. And the overall vMotion time is a lot shorter than with previous vSphere versions. For everything vSphere 7 and a lot more information about vMotion and all the other capabilities and features, please visit this specific URL. Thank you for watching.